The afternoon, hand in blue heelers, now on Scottish. A private videotape ends up in the wrong hands. It's the perfect material for blackmail.
Closing soon, last drinks.
Hi, Chris.
Hi, tough day.
Flat out, with nothing really. A paperwork patrol, more paperwork.
Try running a pub.
You're making me an offer? Better watch out, I might accept it.
You eating?
Yeah, I'll just get changed.
Okay. There's some roast lamb left, but hang on a tick. Okay, that's it, out.
What?
Out.
What are you on about?
You know what I'm on about.
No, I don't.
Don't play the innocent with me. You left here with another bloke only an hour ago.
So?
So I'm the only one running a business in this bar.
I will leave when I bloody well want to leave.
No, you'll leave now before I throw you out.
Well, friend here's gonna buy me a drink. Aren't you, lover?
No, I'm not.
You've had enough for one night?
Says who? I'm still standing, aren't I?
Yeah, well, that's debatable.
Geez, you'll serve a pig and you won't serve me. What sort of a pub is this?
Is there a problem here, Chris?
This young woman refuses to leave.
I've got as much right to be here as the pig does. Or sow.
That's right, sow. She's all yours, Constable.
Thanks a bunch. The landlord's asked you to leave the premises. Are you refusing to do so?
Make me.
If you don't leave, I shall be forced to arrest you. Do you understand that? Chris, let Wayne know we have a guest, will you?
What about a wheelbarrow?
Wayne will have to do.
Anything interesting?
It's a letter from Liz. She's in Helsinki. You think we'll ever do that, just up stakes and take off?
We went to Bali for our honeymoon.
Remember the first night? Little place on the beach.
Yeah, well, I'm afraid I can't manage Bali this year, but would you settle for a Chinese dinner in St. David's for our anniversary?
I thought you'd forgotten.
You'd skin me alive. Maybe you could wear a lizard in your hair in honour of the occasion.
I trust you to remember that, you monster.
Hey, don't hit me. I'm a policeman.
Sorry, sir.
What? Oh. Mm. She's really tied one on.
Well, I wouldn't want to have her head in the morning. Or any day, come to think of it.
I heard that. At least I'm not a cop. You're gonna be sorry for this, you mongrel bitch.
What's your name?
Where do you live?
Who are you?
You're a spunk.
Oh, afraid I'm a cop too.
You can't be cute. I'm Gail. You want a party?
Where do you live, Gail?
You are a cop.
Afraid so.
Then I'm not telling. This girl's gotta have some standards.
It's gonna be a long night.
Oh, well, I hope not. I'm nearly out of my feet now.
Try being the watch house keeper. Gives a whole new meaning to coitus interruptus.
You told us your name, Gail. Now tell us where you live.
Oh, 220, some loose change, no ID.
Get off! Get your filthy paws off me, you bitch.
Tell us where you live, Gail.
Oh, get stuck.
Gail, we'd like to take you home. We need to know where you live.
Wayne, this is hopeless.
Tuck her in, let her sleep it off.
I reckon that's all we can do. Come on, sweetheart.
You get.
Geez, I tell you what, it would be good to have a new car.
What's wrong with the old one?
Oh, it's just past its use by date, that's all. Besides, this new one's a 5-speed manual V8. It's got a ton of grunt.
So how come we're getting it? I mean, Mount Thomas isn't first in line for new gear, is it?
The paperwork has come through. That's all I need to know. Hello, what's this?
Bastard just came at me. They came at my front door and there he was.
What?
That's you, Charlie McBee?
Yeah.
What's the story, Charlie?
It's a private matter.
Can't be that private out here. Who are you?
Peter Maxwell.
Well, can you enlighten us, Mr. Maxwell?
I don't know. The old fart just attacked me. I didn't do a thing.
He knows what he's done.
Yeah, all right, Charlie. Why don't we go down to the station sorted out, eh? Good man.
Yeah, can I lock the door, please?
Hardly appropriate behaviour for a bloke getting over a heart attack, eh, Charlie?
No, I suppose not.
Besides, I'd never have picked you for a street brawl.
Yeah, well.
So what's going on?
I told the constable, Tom. It's a private matter.
So what's the fight all about?
Oh, maybe he doesn't like the way I part my hair. He never liked much else about me.
How do you two know each other?
He used to knock around with his daughter. That was a couple of years ago. It's a bit like to play the irate father.
Come aside. Any joy?
No, ex-boyfriend of the daughter, apparently.
Oh, I'm glad to hear it. Nina's getting married on Saturday.
Uh-huh. What's McVee's story?
He's not talking. Mm. I don't know what could get him that head up.
Yeah, it's out of character, isn't it?
Totally.
Oh, well, Maxwell's looking to press any charges.
Well, in that case, send him on his way. I'll make sure Charlie stays in my office till he's gone.
All right.
Our little ray of sunshine awake, is she?
Yeah, barely.
Fine, I'll tell him. Thank you. Nick, that was Melbourne. Your car's ready to collect.
You beauty.
All right, I don't care what it's about, Charlie, but whatever it is, try and settle it without a punch-up, will you?
Maxwell's gone, boss. Now, mind your car's ready, so I'll off to Melbourne to pick it up.
All right, have fun.
Good day.
On your way, and try and stay out of trouble, will you? I don't think Nina would be too thrilled to have her old man walk her down the aisle sporting two black eyes.
Yeah.
You're kidding.
What's going on?
We got a problem, boss.
Oh. How old did you say you are?
No wonder you get all these deaths in custody. What is this, poison?
How old?
Packing it, are you?
Tell me what you told this officer.
Don't you believe it?
How old are you?
Young enough to get that woman cop into heaps.
How young?
16. I'm 16, okay?
16?
Yeah. I'm a minor, which means I should never have been locked up, which means she is right in it, yeah?
No excuse, Maggie. You were in charge. It was your responsibility.
Yeah, I know
Fair
that.
Fair go, Sarge. I didn't think the girl was underage either. Neither did Chris. I mean, she'd been serving a grog all night.
That's beside the point. She should never have been left alone here overnight in her condition, minor or no minor. She should have been put into a supervised cell.
But we don't have supervised cells.
They do at St. David's.
It was after midnight.
I don't care what time it was. There's a procedure to be followed in cases like this, and it wasn't followed. We're just lucky she didn't throw up and choke herself to death. Now, you smarten up, Maggie. I expect more from you.
Yeah.
Now, go and see if you can find the mother. Croydon? Oh, yeah, g'day, Reg. Well, look, I'm a bit busy at the moment, mate. Can it wait? Well, couldn't you come in here? Yeah, okay, I see. Well, I'll meet you there in about 10 minutes.
What do they expect? Telepathy? That girl's 19 going on 40. Now, we expected to know she's a juvenile.
Yeah, but I was the arresting officer. I should have taken her to St. David's.
What's this I hear about you locking up kids, Mags? You'll be bringing back the booze next.
It's no joke, PJ.
Why are you two still here?
I just spoke to the caravan park, boss. Gail and her mother have an on-site van, no phone, and Mrs. Hatton's not at home at the moment.
Well, she's probably at work.
Apparently not. not a day job, anyway.
Like mother, like daughter.
Well, let's not get judgmental, Constable.
Boss, we've got a social worker on the way over.
Well, that's something, I suppose. Listen, you two go over to the caravan park and see if you can find her anyway, will you? Where's the girl now?
In the interview room.
Keep an eye on her for me, will you? I've got to go out for about half an hour.
Where will you be?
The pub.
The pub?
Anybody home?
Hi, in here.
G'day.
How are you?
Good. Oh, one of those give me a coffee and nobody gets hurt mornings.
Oh, you could say that. Listen, that girl that was in last night making a nuisance of herself, did you ask her for her ID?
She isn't.
I'm afraid she is.
Thought I could pick them.
Oh, don't worry. You weren't the only one. Reg, how are you? In here. You couldn't make that two coffees, could you?
Sure.
And you wouldn't have any bickies, would you?
For you, yes.
If you ate something, Gail, you might feel better.
I'll feel better when I get out of here.
Look, there's a social worker on the way.
I want to go now. You can't hold me. I'm a minor.
Why didn't you say that last night?
Who says I didn't?
The constable who brought you in?
Cops always stick together. Everybody knows that. I'm out of here.
Gail, sit down.
I don't need no social worker.
Sit down.
I've been a bit worried about Charlie, as it happens. He got a little blue with another bloke this morning. Not like him at all.
Nor is this. Hope to God I'm wrong.
You reckon there's about 5,000 missing?
More or less, but I'm no accountant. I just stepped in to give a hand when his missus died.
Have you talked to Charlie about it?
Didn't want to put my foot in it. He's a good bloke. Been a good treasurer for the club.
So what do you want me to do?
You're on the committee. Take a look at the books for me. Check it out. As a committee member, you know what I mean.
So this isn't an official complaint?
God, no. I can't see Charlie ripping us off, can you?
Seems pretty unlikely.
Everything Charlie gave us is in there.
We've picked up the girl's mother. She's in the interview room.
Well, at least something's going right.
Mrs. Hatton, Sergeant Croydon.
Please call me Margot. So what's she been up to now?
Were you aware that she was out last night?
I went out quite early myself and didn't bother to come home in then. She's always been a bit of a handful.
She given you a lot of trouble?
She was drinking on licensed premises, making a nuisance of herself, and refused to leave when requested to do so.
So, look, is she going to be charged? You know, I can't afford to pay any fines.
Well, she's a minor. We'd prefer to avoid taking the matter to court.
They locked me up, Mum. They put me in a cell. I told them I was only 16.
According to my constables, Mrs. Hatton, she was in no fit state to tell them anything of the kind.
Oh, and then that bitch cop, she put her paws all over me. It was awful.
Are you alleging assault by one of my constables now, Miss Hatton?
Dunno. I was pissed, wasn't I?
So can we go now?
I'd just like to point out that better supervision on your part might have helped to avoid all this.
Well, have you ever tried supervising a 16-year-old?
You're just trying to get out of this. She's stuffed up.
You can't blame my mum for that. Come on, Mum.
Spence's eye's okay. I'll just check the oil in the water.
All right. Just get you to sign right here. She's all yours.
G'day. Yep.
Great. Here's your keys. Keep safe.
Cheers, buddy.
Great.
Like their tails are on fire. Boss, show them the four corners of the room.
Not exactly. That little cow's got it in for me. It's personal. You can taste it. You know, Wayne, this could get really nasty. If she gets her mother to complain to Inspector Faulkner and he refers it to Internal Affairs...
Nah, Faulkner wouldn't do that.
If it's a case of protecting his own back, he would in a flash. At the very least, it's a black mark on my file.
Thanks, Tony.
Thanks,
Susan. Lena! Your dad about?
Yeah, he's out the back, checking a delivery. Shall I get him for you?
No, let him finish. How's he getting on?
He has his days. You know, Mum dying really knocked it out of him.
Well, it would. Business okay?
Yeah, it's coming good, actually. I was a bit iffy for a while there.
Well, the recession hurt everyone. This wedding must be setting him back a bit. I mean, Charlie was never one to pinch pennies, as far as you're concerned.
Mean enough, you'll be late for your fitting. Off you go.
Yeah, but I'm still...
Come on. All right, what's going on? I won't have you bothering my girl, Tom. That punch-up this morning...
Hang on. Calm down. This has got nothing to do with that. This isn't an official visit. I've just been having a bit of a chat with Reg. He's got a few worries about some of the footy club accounts.
Oh, God.
The investment account funds? Where's the money, Charlie?
That's quite safe.
Then why don't you just give it back and we'll say no more about it?
I can't.
Charlie.
I can't do it, Tom. I can't give it back.
Why, in heaven's name, if you've still got it?
Look, just don't charge me till after the wedding, Well, Nina, she's all I've got. Gary's a really decent boy from a good family, and she loves him. And she'll be happy and safe, and I won't let anything get in the way of that, or anyone.
This punch-up this morning, has Maxwell got something to do with this? Or maybe Nina could shed some light on a few things.
Keep her out of it, please.
Then talk to me.
I've already paid him once, but that's not enough. He wants more, or he's going to sell the tape. Well, I couldn't have that. I couldn't.
Calm down. He's going to sell what tape?
Oh, some filthy video.
Well, pornographic, you mean? Well, what's a tape like that got to do with you?
Oh, because the girl on the tape is Nina.
Sounded a bit close to the wind, boss. I mean, we're talking embezzlement, not just blackmail.
At the moment, we're talking a short-term loan to a footy club member.
Who was on the tape with your daughter, Mr. McVie?
One who's been blackmailing me. No hope of Peter Maxwell.
How did he approach you?
He sent me the tape.
In the post?
In the post. When I saw what it was, I burned it.
Well, it makes us a bit light on for evidence.
You describe what was on it?
Do I have to?
Well, if we had the tape, we could see for ourselves.
Well, hang on. I suppose you could call it making love, if you're a pervert. I don't blame Nina. She was only a teenager, and she was infatuated.
So after you got the tape, what happened?
He phoned. Said he was going to offer it to a distributor in Canberra. Apparently they buy amateur muck. Said if I wanted to make a better offer, I could. What choice did I have?
So why didn't you come to us?
He said if I told the police, he'd send a copy to Nina's fiancé. Would have ended the marriage before it began.
And that's when you borrowed the money from the footy club?
No, I took the money out of my savings. After the wedding and everything, it's cleaned me out.
So how much did he want?
$2,000. I had to drop it in a waste bin just out of town. I prayed that'd be the end of it.
But he got greedy.
A week later, he phoned. Only this time he wanted $5,000.
He always contacts you by phone?
Always.
Never in writing?
Nope, never.
How well do you know this Peter Maxwell?
Never met him till today.
Then how do you know that it's him?
Well, he's the one on the video. Who else would it be?
He can't give us a thing, boss. No letters, no videotape, nothing. But he still claims he's being blackmailed.
Then he's being blackmailed.
Well, maybe he's trying for a bit of sympathy. You know, after getting caught with his fingers in the till.
You don't know Charlie McVie. His daughter is the most important thing in his life. It's hard enough for him to admit what's happened as it is. There's no way he'd invent it.
Need to question your daughter, Mr. McVee.
Oh, Tom, Nina doesn't know anything about this. I didn't tell her. She'd be so ashamed.
I'm sorry, Charlie. You can rely on Detective Hashem's discretion.
Look, could you give us a bit of time? At least let me tell her myself what's been going on.
Get your story straight, you mean? I'm sorry, Sergeant, but I need to speak to the young lady alone.
Can I at least be here with her?
It's not usual. She's not a minor.
She's also not under suspicion.
Point taken.
Lift me higher, lift me to the sun, lift me to the sky, here comes the sunshine, teach me how to fly.
Lift, instant lemon tea.
Lift me to the sky.
Lift, brightens your day.
You're so impulsive, why don't you try it on first?
It spoke to me, Carol, besides the shop was closing. Ouch, careful, I'm not your pink cushion.
Well, keep still then. Right, turn around.
New Kleenex Double Velvet has a deeper velvet softness.
Oh, it is gorgeous. It's really soft.
I don't know what, though.
No, I think it is taking in a bit, around the middle.
Do you think so? There must be all that jogging.
What, to the fridge?
Very funny.
It's so much softer and thicker, we've had to make the middle thinner.
Right, how does it fit?
Perfect.
Oh, it doesn't look bad.
You could do me jeans.
So much softer and thicker, the middle's thinner. New Kleenex Double Velvet Toilet Tissue. Start your day the wrong way, and you never know when hunger might catch up with you.
Ha-ha! Hunger strikes!
But start the day with Shreddies, and each one is packed with layer upon layer of whole wheat for a deliciously malted taste that keeps hunger locked up till lunch. So don't you forget...
Ha-ha!
Shreddies and frosted Shreddies keep hunger locked up till lunch.
Ladies, discover wet shaving the feminine way with Lady Protector from Wilkinson Sword. So gentle because it's behind bars. It gives an unbeatably safe shave, a silky smoothness and closeness the natural way. At last, your own wet shaving system. Lady Protector from Wilkinson Sword.
Today, he's already taught Maisie to scuba dive. Invited a few friends for lunch. And still found time to paint his sister. But right now, he's being as good as gold. His mum has given him Petit Filou. Real French fromage frais. It's thick, creamy and full of fruity goodness. And he can use some. Ask Teddy. This afternoon, he's having flying lessons. Petit Filou. A little goodness for little rascals.
How do McVitie's make wheatables so deliciously snappy? The secret is oven baking at four different temperatures. First hot, then very warm to bring out the flavour. Next, extremely hot to make them light and crisp. Then a final golden toasting. McVitie's Wheatables.
Very snappy, very tasty.
Try another flavour. Oak smoked ham, chili beef?
No, stick with the cream cheese and chives.
Ignore him. He's just plain devil's advocate.
You have to go a long, long way to find a snappier snack biscuit.
Talk about that inside, eh?
Dad.
Hello, love.
Will someone tell me what's going on?
We just need to ask you a few questions, Nina.
It's all right, love. They just
it's fine, thank you, sir. Now, someone called Peter Maxwell?
Peter? Why? Something happened to him?
No, he's okay.
Could you tell us what your relationship is?
We don't have a relationship.
But you did.
I went out with him for a while, yes.
For how long?
I don't know, 6, 8 months.
And when did you stop seeing him?
When I met Gary, my fiancé, 2 years ago. What's this all about?
Nina, I need to ask you something personal. Did you ever have sex with Peter?
No. No, I liked him,
but
no... Quite sure.
Nina. You know you're lying.
Look, just... tell them the truth. Hmm? I'll wait outside.
Oh, no. He hasn't got AIDS or anything, has he?
This couldn't be happening to me.
Nina, it's okay. As far as we know, he's fine.
Does Dad know about it? I mean, he hated Peter.
Why is that?
I don't know. It's not as if they even met. Dad just hated the idea of him.
Nina, I need to ask you one more thing. Did Peter Maxwell ever videotape you having sex?
No! No, what do you think I am?
Your father says Maxwell sent him a tape of the two of you. Now he's trying to blackmail him.
Yeah, well, in fairness, Ted, the girl didn't look like a juvenile. Yes, sir. I know it's no excuse, and I have reminded all my officers of correct procedure. Well, of course, if you have a formal complaint, you have to act on it, and you have, Ted. You've spoken to me. Doyle's a good officer, and we can only hope it goes no further. Yes, sir. Three bags full, sir.
Thanks, Nina. We'll be in touch.
What happens now?
I'll leave it with us, sir.
But
obviously, if the blackmailer tries to contact you, you should let us know.
That poor kid. How would you cope knowing your dad had seen a video of you having it off with some bloke?
Well, out of Mongolia would look attractive.
Doyle, a word.
It's ominous.
Yeah, Inspector Faulkner just called.
The Gail Hatton business. The mother's just made a formal complaint.
Okay, so what happens now?
Depends. Ted Faulkner may be prepared to let it go as a formal rebuke, which I've already delivered.
It's just not fair, you know. The girl didn't look underage, and she was certainly in no state to give us any information. What were we supposed to do? Turn her out into the gutter?
Oh, you know the answer to that one, Doyle.
Yeah.
Sounds like the new car's arrived.
Now, the info sign's got 30 precept memories accessed by this computer gizmo here.
What is this, Robocop, Nick?
It's pretty state-of-the-art, mate.
Oh, my word, ABS brakes. It's got a new suspension system, including thicker torsion bars. And look at this!
Oh, it's an engine.
Bloody reckon, boss, isn't he a beauty?
Well, at least we'll save on a Christmas tree this year.
I appreciate it.
It was supposed to be our anniversary, a night to remember. We'll remember this all right.
Don't blame me.
Don't blame you. Why did you have to go on about it all night?
I didn't. All I said...
I know what you said, Wayne.
All I said is that Maggie's copping the rough end of the pineapple and you don't seem to care.
Don't you think I might have had enough of Maggie for one day? I mean, if you're so concerned about her, why don't you take her out for dinner instead?
You're not jealous.
Of course I'm not jealous. Why would I be jealous?
I mean, me and Maggie, that was a long time ago.
That's right. It's in the past. I mean, you wouldn't be jealous of Sam.
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 Who's Sam?
Oh, just someone.
What do you mean, someone?
Just someone.
Will you tell me? I want to know.
Well, Sam is someone I made up.
But it's irritating, isn't it? And you don't have to work with him every day.
I thought you liked Maggie.
I do like Maggie. And I like lobster thermidor as well, but I don't want it for breakfast, lunch and dinner. Food tonight was great, though. Now I expect you want me to come across. I know your type.
How does this guy own a crust?
He's a painter, apparently. Mostly portraits. Chris says he does all right.
Mr. Maxwell. We met yesterday. This is Constable Doyle.
Don't tell me.
McVee's claiming I assaulted him?
No, not exactly. Can we come in?
Peter, are you going to be long? I'm getting cold.
Yeah, take a break, sweetheart. Something's come up.
It's a bit awkward.
Well, perhaps you prefer to come down to the station.
Yeah, well, I'll just get cleaned up.
How well did you know Nina McVee?
That's ancient history.
Why? How well?
Pretty well.
You had a relationship?
A relationship? What kind of crap's that? We had sex, if that's what you mean. I mean, why do you want to know?
We gather you made a videotape.
What?
Of you and her?
Yeah, well, call me sentimental. I like them to look back on.
Them?
Yeah, I have a lot of friends.
And these friends are happy for you to videotape them?
Some are.
And the ones who aren't?
They don't have to know.
We'd like to see the one of Nina.
Yeah, so would I.
What?
He was knocked off.
Uh-huh. So what happened?
Oh, somebody broke in one night.
Well, did you report it?
Yeah, of course I reported it. You have a record of that back there somewhere. They walked off in a VCR, and a CD player, and a record player too.
So what was all the equipment I saw at your place?
It's all replacement stuff. You know, insurance.
Yeah, but you got two VCRs. There was one in your bedroom.
So?
So I think we should go back and take a look at the serial number.
Okay. The VCR wasn't stolen.
So where's the rest of the stuff?
Oh, well, that went. But I just took the CD player and the record player.
Ah. So you made a false claim.
Yeah, well, everybody does it. The insurance company can stand it.
Do they?
What made you split up, Peter?
What?
You and Nina, why did you split?
You get tired of them. You know what it's like.
So no hard feelings?
No, why should there be?
Well, I heard she dumped you.
She dumped me? No, I dumped her.
Are you sure about that?
Nobody dumps me. I mean, who fed you this crap anyway?
She got to you, did she?
Little bitch. I bet it was her. I bet she ripped the gear off. Women, you can't trust them.
Now, I want them back. I've got a lot of beautiful memories in that lot.
Somebody's gonna have to check all these out.
I wonder who.
You know me, Mags. Stickler for duty.
PJ.
Hey, boss.
I'll take those, thank you.
But why, boss?
Because I won't enjoy them as much as you.
Yeah, I know, but the VCR is in my office.
Then we'll just have to move it into my office, won't we?
How's it going, boss?
I thought he said some of these women were happy to be videoed.
I probably thought it was a lark. Oh, a bit of a turn on.
I know we live in libertarian times, but it's not just a few nude photos, it's a full action spectacular.
Yeah. Well, you recognize anyone?
One or two. And I'm glad I'm not their father. Hey, hang on, PJ, have a look at this.
Yeah? What?
Well, this is Maggie's collar. This is Gail Hatton.
Thought she was only 16.
Yeah. Well, one way or another, our friend Maxwell's in more trouble than he knows. But for the moment, let's just concentrate on the blackmail, shall we?
Wayne?
Yeah, boss?
You went out to that break-in at Peter Maxwell's place a couple of months ago. Do you remember anything about it?
What do you mean?
Will anything strike you as odd?
Well, it seemed okay at the time. Anyway, I would have said if something seemed odd.
No possibility it was a set-up job.
Back door had been forced. Seemed legit.
He admitted cleaning for a VCR that wasn't stolen. Maybe he set up the burglary, give himself an alibi.
Maybe. Get him in again, PJ.
Yep.
Why ask me? It's obvious he's blackmailing him. Whoever nicked the tape?
The problem is, Peter, we've got no proof it was nicked.
You'll swear they took it with the other stuff.
Peter's just given his word the tape was stolen.
Oh, good. As the insurance company knows, that's something we can rely on.
Okay. Yeah, I put one over on them. But blackmail? I mean, come on, I'm not the guy you want.
You made the videotape.
I know, I made the tape.
And you were hung up on his daughter?
Not anymore.
You didn't seem too happy when we asked you about it before.
How many times am I going to tell you guys? I'm not the guy you want.
How much do you think this tape would be worth? $2,000, $5,000? This is your bank statement?
You know it is.
You put $2,000 in your account the day Charlie McVie paid the money over.
I sold a painting.
You sold a painting?
Yeah, a nude to a collector in Melbourne. I can give you the receipt.
Probably just as kosher as the insurance claim.
BJ, I'd like a word.
What is it?
Charlie's just had another phone call.
Guy wants me to drop the money same as before. Tomorrow morning, first thing.
I guess this puts Casanova in the clear. He's got a blackmail charge.
Unless he's got a partner. In any case, I want him kept under lock and key. At the very least, we've still got him on the insurance fraud.
Can't tempt you?
I'm
not tonight, Chris. I've got another start.
Good night, then.
Good night. Oh, Maggie. Listen, what happened to that kid I tossed out of here? Don't remind me.
Giving you a headache, is she?
She and her mother have made a formal complaint.
Oh, typical.
Chris, you saw the state she was in. What was I supposed to do?
She's a spoiler, you know. I've seen that type before. They're nothing but trouble.
She wasn't giving me such grief. I could actually feel sorry for the kid. The mother's got nil parenting experience. There's no father.
So who has the perfect childhood? Most of us just get on with it and do the best we can.
Yeah. Maybe you're right. Anyway, good night.
Good night.
There was the money dropped off near this picnic area in a waste bin.
It's pretty open there. There's not a lot of cover for us.
Whatever it is, they've thought it through.
Well, we'll use this hill here as an observation area. Maggie, that's your job. PJ and Nick, block off Oxford Road here and here. Wayne, you here. As soon as he picks up, we grab him.
Just one thing, boss.
Mm-hmm.
He told Charlie if he came to us, he'd send the tape to his daughter's fiancé.
Why would he do that? He's not going to get anything.
Except satisfaction.
He won't have a chance once we nail him.
Yeah, what if it's arranged? What if there's someone else involved?
Like Billy, you mean?
Look, I take your point, Maggie, but we don't have much choice, do we? Now, do we all know what we're doing?
Yep.
Yep. All right, then let's get to it.
Yep.
Any sign of Charlie, Wayne?
Not yet.
Nick?
Negative, Sarge. What about your end, PJ?
No movement here.
Here comes Charlie now.
Movement yet?
No, nothing. Hang on.
There's a tractor coming from the property opposite.
Not exactly a fast getaway car.
Yeah, it looks like Clary Spinks.
Ignore Clary and concentrate on the money.
There's a trail bike entering the picnic area from the creek.
Okay, he's made the pickup. It's our man.
He's heading north up Oxford Road.
Nick, he's headed your way.
Oh, oh, oh.
Look what you've done to my car!
At Farm Foods freezer centres, you'll find everything at surprisingly low prices.
Guess how much?
$2.39?
Way below! They're only $1.89!
Four Ross Chip Shop Cod or Haddock portions approved by Harry Ramsden's just $1.89.
Guess how much?
$1.89?
Way below! It's only $1.39!
1 litre of Nestlé Summer Strawberry Ice Cream is just $1.39. Farm Foods. Our prices are way below.
My name is Gary Lydiard. I'm a makeup artist in the motion picture business. The camera sees everything. Everybody wants long, luscious lashes. Before I started using stretch mascara, I used to have to put a liner on the back of the lashes. The crisscross brush covers the base of the lash all the way to the front. It's really important to us to try and get that long look. And with the stretch mascara, you can achieve that.
The makeup of makeup artists. Max Factor International.
How can such rich, thick, Müller Lite really be a low-fat yogurt? Anything's possible.
Müller Lite. From Müller, who else?
Booking for cheaper car insurance? Call the Admiral on 0800 600 800. You could save pounds because you deal direct with us. No middlemen, no commissions to pay. We'll give you an instant quote. You can even pay by instalments. We're open until 10 p.m. and the call is free. So call the Admiral now on 0800 600 800.
Admiral 0800 600 800.
To make McVitie's Fruit and Nut United, you need currants, hazelnuts, special McVitie's biscuit, loads of milk chocolate, a house brick, and an elephant. You see, McVitie's don't use just any old chocolate. They've developed their very own finer, smoother, more chocolatey chocolate by using pressures equivalent to a 5-ton elephant standing on a brick. Here we are, Tracy. Here's a good girl.
You have to go a long, long way to find a better biscuit.
That's my foot, Tracy.
It wasn't my idea. It was her.
Who?
Gail. Gail Hatton.
Gail Hatton? She gets around?
Well, we were having a drink one night and she told me about these videos.
Videos?
Yeah, the porn one some artist guy had. What was his name? Peter somebody. Anyway, she said we could make some cash out of them.
How?
People would pay to get them back.
And you went along with it?
It was her idea.
Did she do the break-in? Did she do the break-in, Craig?
No.
Did she make any of the phone calls to Charlie McVee?
No.
No. Then what did she do?
I told you, it was her idea.
How do we know that you didn't knock off the videos and when you saw what they were...
No, I'm telling you!
We're ending the interview, mate. You have to do better than that. Better check out your place.
Hey, I'm not taking all the blame. Hey, what about her?
Never heard of him.
You've never heard of Peter Maxwell? Then perhaps you could explain how come the two of you appear together on a videotape.
What tape? How should I know?
Constable, why don't you fetch the tape from the safe? We need to refresh this young lady's memory.
Okay. So I let him video us in bed. It was a bit of fun. There's no law against it, is there? You bloody idiot.
So, you do know Peter Maxwell. What about Craig Dawson?
That creep. He's always wanted me to go out with him.
Is that all?
That's enough. Have you smelled his breath?
He says it was your idea to blackmail Charlie McVee.
Who?
He says it was your idea to steal the videos.
What videos?
Craig Dawson says the blackmail was your idea and that you were going to get half the money.
Well, it would, wouldn't it?
I'd like to speak to your mother alone. Would you wait outside, please? Thank you.
Mrs. Cozy.
Mrs. Hatton.
Margot.
Mrs. Hatton, you and your daughter are making a lot of trouble for a very good young officer. And we both know your claims are ungrounded.
She locked Gail up. We deserve some compensation.
Gail was falling down drunk, Mrs. Hatton, not, I gather, for the first time. If she were a little younger, we'd be speaking to a care and protection order. Well, she's been involved in the making of illegal videos.
Oh, look, she's a kid. She's stupid.
Not to mention the attempted blackmail.
She said she didn't know anything about it.
Well, I don't believe it, do you?
So what do you want me to do?
She's your daughter. You could try for once in your life to be a proper mother to her. She's 16 years old, for heaven's sake. She should have the whole of her life to look forward to.
Why? When I was her age, I didn't have the whole of my life to look forward to. I had her.
All the more reason to help her now. The city has better resources. Social workers.
Yeah. In other words, get out of Mount Thomas and stay out.
I can arrange a referral through the regional social worker.
Keep your pity. And your referrals.
We're charging Maxwell with obtaining property by deception. Young Dawson will go down for burglary and handling as well as blackmail. But I'm afraid he's already spent your original $2,000.
No, more fool me for paying it in the first place. But what about the video?
It's in my safe.
Can't you destroy it?
It's evidence. Don't worry, if we need to show it, the court will be closed and I'll make sure it's wiped as soon as the case is over. So, you and Nina sorted things out?
Oh, starting to. My business with Maxwell, you realise she's grown up, you know? Really grown up, making her own decisions and her own mistakes.
Girls, eh? More of a worry than boys.
Charlie, if Nina's on the phone, there's some problem with the flowers.
Speak of the devil, eh? Ah, Doyle. I've just had word from St. David's. Mrs. Hatton has withdrawn her complaint.
Thanks, boss. I thought I was a goner.
I'm sure she just thought better of it, Doyle.
What about blackmail?
Oh, well, it's his word against hers, but I wouldn't be surprised if she and her daughter decided to move on, though.
St. Kilda or the Cross?
Oh, come on, Doyle. You're getting a bit cynical in your old age. Oh, a fresh start will be good for both of them.
Somebody else's problem, eh, boss?
It's an imperfect world, Doyle.
This bloke's a one-man crime wave.
Is that the last of the video?
Yeah, and I swear I didn't look at him, boss.
Good.
Hey, Schultzy.
Take the barrels after your blood.
What?
Well, you pinched his new car, didn't you?
What are you talking about?
Right district. Wrong station.
Hey?
Well, the district officer reckons that Mount Thomas isn't big enough to carry the new wagon. You better utilise it at the 24-hour station.
Oh, get out of it. You're out of your tree.
Oh, sorry, Schultz. You know how it is.
Hey, you folks had anything to do with it, though, did you?
Oh, we wouldn't do that to you, Schultz.
It was nice while it lasted.
Oh, pleased to see you taking it on the chin.
Well, don't forget to sign the logbook, eh?
Oh, yeah, right.
Good on you. Belt up and drive safe.
Won't Barrett go spare when he sees the damage?
No. Well, you saw for yourself, Hannon signed for it, didn't he? And I quote, vehicle received in good and working condition. He's got to explain the damage. Nothing to do with me, mate. But I wouldn't mind being a fly on the wall when he finds out.
We'll be right back. I have to choose between my family and friends.
Are you off your trolley?
Or Tina. There's no choice.
Emmerdale, tonight at 5:10 on Scottish.